What's the best way for you to define how you and your teammates feel about the fact you were up 2-0 and now it's tied 2? Are you angry, disappointed? What's the right, if those aren't the right words, what is the right way to do this?
Okay, see, playing well, last game. It's serious. You know, like I said, the team's not just gonna go away without fighting. You know, it came down to a couple possessions. We watched it, and what happened. It's just about, you know, bouncing back and, you know, preparing for game 5. You know, we're not focused on games. You know, one before you worry on to the next. You know, just how what we, you know, giving away the game. So, you know, we've done that, and now we're about to address a couple things and, you know, move forward, prepare for game 5.
Hey Rob, what have you seen defensively in the past 2 games that you didn't see in the first 2, just from an effort or energy standpoint?
You said, what have I seen as far as us or the other team?
Yeah, you guys.
I mean, not too much, nothing different that we did. You know, it's just, you know, they've got, you know, they watched film and made adjustments, and, you know, now it's time for us to make adjustments. So, you know, we've just been, you know, getting you know, too many drives, too many, you know, their shots, and, you know, just being more mindful of, you know, our sense of urgency a little bit.
Thank you.
John Fagan?
You mentioned giving up drives. That's normally the strength of your defense. Do you feel like that can be improved, or is that part of you play the Thunder, they're going to get some drives?
They're definitely going to get drives, but it's just about, you know, our rotations and, you know, being more alert. You know, we're going over some stuff today, and just going to make, we're going to make adjustments. We're already, you know, preparing for that, and, you know, seeing how the first 4 games went, and now they're, you know, game 5 is going to be a different, you know, approach, and, you know, moving forward, you know, just got to take it, like I said, 1 game at a time, and, you know, to get this next one.
Thanks.
Christy Regan? Now that the series is tied up, is there like a mindset shift that you have to have since they've kind of stolen the momentum away in order to get back on track and do what you guys want to do in the series?
No, we just got to keep preparing and, you know, keep going. We just got to have a higher sense of urgency and higher, you know, energy level to, you know, go ahead and, you know, get these games together and then, you know, actually finish them out, because, like you said, that run at the end of the third quarter is what, you know, really hurt us. And we watched how it happened, and, you know, to close our games, we can't have those type of moments. So, you know, just teams are going to make runs, but how do you affect it? How do you stop it? You know, that's what we got to be more mindful and conscious of, and that's what we've, you know, addressed. And, you know, moving forward, we're going to have different, you know, approach and different, you know, viewpoint on things.
Haley Griffin.
Hey, Rob. Fouls have been up down in Orlando. The team shot 10 free throws last night to OKC's 28. Is there a point of concern in terms of the number of fouls being committed, or maybe a point of emphasis in terms of looking to draw more fouls?
That's on the ref's perception. You know, we can't control that aspect. You know, we feel like it'd be missed calls, but, you know, that's not on us to sit up there and, you know, we just got to keep, you know, playing within our offense. We just allow us to, you know, keep going, we're going, and not let, sometimes we go in and we get fouled, sometimes we don't. We just can't let it, you know, keep, we just gotta keep sticking to the game plan, and we can't, you know, just focus on that aspect.
Ryan Bearfield.
Robert, the NBA has taken a very proactive approach as far as social injustice is concerned. You know, you all have Black Lives Matter on the court, you all have the messages on the back of your jerseys, but how does it feel, or what do you all talk about when you see something that has happened in Wisconsin, another unarmed African-American male shot by police officers?
You know, we are doing all this to, you know, really, you know, bring about awareness, and, you know, it's not too much that's been done. Every day we fear, you know, going outside, friends, family, never know, you know, you might get a phone call that said that, you know, someone that's close to you, you know, might not make it to see the next day. And, you know, that's a scary sight to, you know, be having that feeling, you know, growing up in this world right now, because, like you said, it's not nothing being done for it. I may have heard y'all make the comment earlier about, you know, Breonna Taylor, they still have yet to do anything about her and, you know, the cops that killed her. And, you know, it's an ongoing fight. We've been, you know, advocates about this for the longest. And, you know, like I said, it's just people are not, they're not taking the initiative, not taking the approach, and they just fully should. And, you know, like I said, we're going to keep pushing. We're going to keep, you know, we're not going to stay silent. We're not going to, you know, stop. We're gonna keep pushing and we're gonna keep moving forward to, you know, keep bringing awareness. And, you know, me and our brotherhood, you know, we're gonna do everything in our power to, you know, not let this thing die down, because this is a worldwide epidemic. You know, racism is heavily, and, you know, over the course of the last few years, things have been more, you know, prominent. So, you know, it's just, you know, it's being shown a lot. And, you know, the police brutality and stuff has always been there, but now we're actually standing up and fighting for it, as our ancestors did, because it's hard. You know, like I said, you know, I'm afraid for my brothers, you know, my sisters, you know, my future children. You know, if things don't change, like, how do you sit up and have these conversations to prepare your children about, you know, what could potentially happen in the world and how to address it, and not, you know, be walking around in fear? Because, you know, like I said, you social media, you have access to it so much. And all this stuff is being video recorded and nothing's being done about it. So how do you think it's gonna make people feel? That's one thing, that's the scariest thing to think about when it comes to this.
Mark Medina.
Robert, how do you deal with that fear given the magnitude?
Man, you just gotta take it every day. It's just be, you know, as you are, you have to be conscious of a lot. And, you know, like I said, it's not a lot of people that are like that. But you have to have that approach. You have to have the mindset that, you know, you have to be smart in them situations, because you never know. You have to think thoroughly through it. And, you know, it does feel a lot. You know, I'm a figure that, you know, I've had run-ins with, you know, police before, and, you know, and it hasn't been minor. It's been something very minor for playing football on the street. Like, just something as that simple, and, you know, having a cop tell you that, you know, he'll break your legs, like, if you don't do what I say. Like, little stuff like that, like, it triggers you. But I never let it fully affect me, because, like I said, you know, my uncle was a cop. My uncle's one of them good people that, you know, did right by, you know, what he abided by. So, you know, it's not everyone that's like that. You know, there's good and bad, but it just takes the time to sit up here and just evaluate it all.